I'm Cameron Johnson. I started my first business when I was 9 years old, made my first $1 million before I was 17. You could say I know a little bit about business. Strap in, because this is Beat the Boss USA.
Three bright sparks.
We're kids. We know what we like.
Three big shots.
I can't wait.
Two new products.
It's all going downhill.
But only one team can win.
Who did they vote as the overall winner?
Beat the Boss.
I'm Cameron Johnson, and this is Beat the Boss USA. Today, the Bright Sparks and the Big Shots are going to go head-to-head to create a brand new twist on one of America's favorite desserts, the cheesecake. The question is, who knows what you really want?
Today's Bright Sparks are Laura, Harry, and Sierra. First up, Laura from Cardiff. She's a drama queen who wants to steal the show from the Big Shots.
Big Shots, there's no way you're going to beat this drama queen.
Next, Harry from London, a budding animator who likes to call the shots, and he's focused on beating the Big Shots.
Big Shots, I've already written the script, and guess what? You're gonna lose.
And helping them understand the American market is Sierra from Los Angeles. She's never bored when she's down at the beach, and she plans to make waves with the Big Shots.
Big Shots, prepare to be wiped out.
They're the Bright Sparks, now let's bring on the Big Shots.
They are David, Cheryl, and Ryan. First up is entrepreneur and radio guru, David. With over 30 years in showbiz, he hosts a technology radio show and is one of America's talk radio stars.
Bright Sparks, I have thought of and dismissed more products than you are days old. You are going down hard.
Next, Cheryl, boss of a talent agency in Beverly Hills. She's always on the lookout for the next big thing.
I've been here for years, and believe me, no one is going to beat this boss.
And Ryan, sales manager with an international sales company. He's driven to succeed and loves closing deals.
Bright Sparks, I close business deals before you've even finished eating your breakfast. You may as well go take a walk.
So those are our two teams, the Big Shots, who are the cream of the crop, and the Bright Sparks, who know what tickles your taste buds. Both teams have their sights set on one goal, to win the Beat the Boss trophy. It's time to deliver the brief.
Good morning, Bright Sparks.
Morning.
Laura and Harry, how's LA?
Big.
Big.
Big?
Yeah,
everything's big.
Good morning, Big Shots. How are you feeling?
Good morning.
I'm ready.
I'm excited. We got to go out there and show the kids who's really the boss.
Sierra, how are you going to bring Laura and Harry up to speed on the American market?
LA is my town. I know it really, really well. I've been here since I was a kid.
What would be the worst brief?
There really isn't anything that we can think of.
No, bring it on.
Anything to do with food, really.
Whatever it is, it's going to be fantastic. And just talking with my teammates, we're ready.
Something edible which can go wrong really easily.
Are you ready to receive your brief? Today's challenge will have your taste buds tingling. Your team has to create a brand new type of cheesecake that kids will love. It must have a whole new flavor, and most importantly, it must look great on the plate.
Awesome.
Cheesecake.
That's awesome.
Oh my god.
You said the magic word, cheesecake.
Yeah. Is this supposed to be a challenge?
Laura, you look a bit nervous.
I don't know what an American cheesecake is.
Cheesecake is one of the USA's top-selling desserts, with Americans munching through around $700 million of this stuff every year. There are dozens of flavors already out there, so creating something new in this super-sized market is going to be tough.
Now I'm going to send you off to do some market research. You know what kids want, but Laura and Harry, you need to use Sierra to learn the American market. You have to get into the minds of kids to find out what flavors of cheesecake they like and also how they like it presented to them. You only have one day to come up with an all-new type of cheesecake. Do you want my advice? Get moving.
I'm a little bit worried because I don't know what cheesecake is, but we'll give it a go.
My confidence shot through the roof because look at me, you're talking about food. I mean, I can't wait.
I've sent both teams off to do their market research. The Bright Sparks are heading to an all-American restaurant where Sierra can start by showing Harry and Laura exactly what an American cheesecake is.
So that's a cheesecake.
That looks so nice.
Yum.
So big.
Oh. I think there might be more.
More.
More. Strawberry.
Oh. That looks strawberry. This look at that one. My favorite.
Is it? You gotta try that one.
Very good.
Chocolate mousse cheesecake. That looks so nice. There's cheesecake everywhere.
This morning, Laura and Harry, they didn't really know what cheesecake was, but now they've been introduced to it and know the flavors. It's probably going to end up being their favorite dessert very soon.
The big shots have taken the battle onto the streets. They aim to meet some children and find out what flavors hit the spot.
Ladies, I'm sorry. I don't want to ruin your day, but I just wanted to make it better, actually.
Well, what we're trying to do today is we're trying to figure out the most favorite cheesecake ever for kids, okay?
There's some flavors here, and I've already actually taken a little bit of bites of these, but if you guys can try one of them, let me give you a spoon here.
I'd like you to taste whatever one you want and tell me what your thoughts are.
That's really good.
It's clear the cheesecake is a big hit with their target market. But which flavors are coming out on top?
I like the creamy chocolatey part.
Cookies and cream.
Oh. I always get chocolate.
Probably the peanut butter.
I would like peanut butter and chocolate.
The Big Shots are doing a great job with their market research, asking kids what flavors they like, but they haven't asked them what textures they like or what kind of shapes. And part of this challenge is the presentation, how the cheesecake looks on the plate. If they're gonna come up with something new, they've gotta challenge the way things are done.
Back at the restaurant, Harry and Laura are about to take their very first taste of American cheesecake. What will they think?
Bad.
I tried this one, it tastes like ice cream.
This one's really chocolate.
Let's try the peanut butter.
I like the cookie dough part, tastes like a cookie.
Can you try that? The cheesecakes are really creamy and really nice, but I really can't eat that much.
People like strawberries in America?
Yes, very. I think a good idea would be combining the tanginess of the strawberry, but not with the original, but with the ice cream vanilla bean would be so much better.
And Sierra has really helped because of now we know, like, what American kids would like.
It's been really useful finding out which flavors go together and seeing which ones don't.
I think the chocolate's a bit too much chocolate.
Too much chocolate.
Too much chocolate? More like too much cheesecake. Time to get some expert advice from restaurant manager Brent.
So what's the top-selling cheesecake?
Top-selling cheesecake? I think you actually demolished that one. It was a fresh strawberry cheesecake. Kids actually really love the cookies and cream cheesecake.
We're British and we have to come up with an American cheesecake. Have you got any ideas?
I think anything big, like think of a big dollop of whipped cream, maybe some chocolate sauce all over the top.
So the kids really like that type of presentation.
Yes.
Big.
That's, you see a lot of big, nice, beautiful whipped cream dollops and the kids usually like that.
So some tasty tips from Brent. Over to the Big Shots, who are off to a kids' cookery school to find out how their target market likes their desserts presented.
Perfect. I think maybe we should make these two the eyes and make maybe like a smiley face.
So you guys are giving me a lot of colors here.
What's the next color you want?
Orange.
Orange, of course. Yellow, then orange.
It's like being in an art class. You know, it's like being in an art class and having a whole bunch of finger paints and the direction is get as messy as is humanly possible.
But in all the mess, Ryan has spotted something interesting in the way the desserts are being presented.
So Sydney, you made a little character here. Is it important to make your food into like a little character so there's a theme to it?
Yeah, because then it's like more fun and you can, and like, it's fun looking at it, but then you like eat it.
Yeah.
And then there's the mouth and someone's smiling and the nose coming down.
Oh,
that's pretty creative.
It's clear the face theme leaves a smile on the chef's faces. Now, Sierra is taking her teammates on a shopping trip to get an idea of what other ingredients could go in their cheesecake.
There's some chocolate and peanut butter.
Do you like chocolate and peanut butter?
Yeah, they love that.
So much choice.
Yeah, look at all of this.
Things like chocolate and vanilla coverings that become hard after you dip them in the fruits.
We're going up and down the aisles looking at different combinations of flavors and different textures, which is giving us loads of different ideas.
Here we can find a combination of chocolate peanut butter. See? Look. Kids really, really like the taste. It's chocolate and peanut butter. Really good.
Americans obsessed with peanut butter.
That's what kids here like.
Sierra's made me concentrate a bit more on what the kids want, not what I want.
Both teams have completed their market research, but which one has done enough to beat the competition? It's time for the brainstorm.
Something that hasn't been seen before.
A new flavor.
At least to
so
look good.
A combination of flavors would be good. And look great on the plate. So we're gonna have to find a good shape.
Inside out cheesecake balls. With the crust and the graham on the outside, but the cheesecake and the toppings would be on the inside. It would be really good.
Wow, they've come up with an idea right away. Can the big shots match them?
So what I'm thinking is, what if we come up with a flavor that is sort of a great flavor all on its own, but that we give them little samples of like the gummy bears.
Like
and
in a yogurt shop or something.
Exactly.
They can create their
exactly.
own.
Or build a cheesecake. Build your own cheesecake.
That's sure.
Right. Okay.
So both teams are off to a quick start, but the Bright Sparks are stumbling at the first hurdle. They're overcomplicating their cheesecake balls with too many layers.
One layer, two layer, three layer, four layer, five layer, six layer. Six layer is
the
crust.
How did you get six?
There's three flavors. There's honey, strawberry, vanilla, and there's cookie dough chocolate. But the problem is with the layering on the inside of the balls that we keep changing that idea. So I think that might be a problem right now.
The big shots are racing ahead. Happy with their build your own idea, they are using their market research to cook up a tasty flavor.
But the slam dunk that we had today was the cookies and cream.
Okay.
How many kids talked about cookies and cream, ice cream that they like?
Well, it's a straight sweet taste, right? It's chocolate and cream.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So it's not something that would clash with other things. It would be enhanced by other things.
Right.
Hey, Bright Sparks.
Hi.
How's it going?
Good.
Our design was that we have a full strawberry in the center with vanilla mousse like encasing it with strawberry sauce and then more vanilla going around it and then some white chocolate and a crust.
And is your plan to have several cheesecake balls?
Yeah, we're probably going to have about three.
How big is the ball going to be if you're going to have that many layers? It sounds like it's going to be a basketball.
The layers of chocolate will be just as thin as a piece of paper.
Just to separate
the flavors.
Okay. All right, I think you're off to a good start and you've got some good ideas. I think you're just going to have to narrow your focus. I want to make sure that you have a final product. Can you do that?
Yes, we can.
Okay, all right, good luck.
What we learned when we watched the kids put their stuff together is they love building stuff.
Right.
So what we're gonna do is we're gonna give them little samples around the plate. We're gonna call it Build Your Own Cheesecake, right? Sure. So what we looked for was a flavor that was good on its own or it could be enhanced. And what we came up with was cookies and cream.
It seems like a cop-out. It seems like, okay, so our mission is to give kids their favorite cheesecake. So let's just give them a slice of cheesecake and let's give them every single topping.
Well, let's talk about the cheesecake. It's a new enough flavor and it's a great enough flavor that we think it stands on its own.
So something has to be narrowed versus just bringing them a bunch of stuff
exactly.
and letting them make
I
something.
Think we can figure that out, too.
Let's iron out the details and I'll check back with you. The Bright Sparks have decided to simplify their idea, but now they have another problem. They need a name.
Cheesecake.
Okay.
Inside out trio.
I think we found your name.
Aisle.
Inside out trio.
The big shots are nearly done. Now they're deciding how to arrange the toppings for their build your own cheesecake.
Remember, we're doing a round cheesecake now. That we've settled
right?
So if we do one, two, three, four, like a smile, right? And maybe we make the strawberries and whipped cream as two eyes.
Bright Sparks, pitch me your idea.
Inside out trio.
Sure.
Tasty cheesecake from the inside out.
Do you think you've created a great product? Do you think you're gonna win?
It'll either be really good or it completely stink.
Yeah, disaster.
You've got a great product. Now you're gonna have to pitch it. You're gonna be pitching your idea to a leading American company who's gonna actually produce your cheesecake. You can either win it or lose it in the pitch. You've got a great story, but if you can't tell it, you're not going to be able to sell it. So have you got a product?
So we call it My Own Cheesecake. The eyes are the whipped cream and sliced strawberries, which the kid can put on the cheesecake. The nose is the big piece of cheesecake.
This is the absolute best idea you can come up with.
We think.
Think isn't good enough, especially in this world. The Bright Sparks Inside Out Trio has three balls of cheesecake, and the Big Shots My Own Cheesecake has a face-shaped design. In preparation for the pitch, the Bright Sparks have created some colorful visuals, but the Big Shots have gone all out and baked their own prototype. The pressure's on as both teams must now pitch their ideas to the Cheesecake Factory, America's leading cheesecake company. They'll be pitching to Philip, the company's big cheese. It's time for the teams to come face to face.
Oh, I don't think the Bright Sparks have anything to bring to the table like ours. I think ours is going to blow them out of the water.
My message to the Big Shot says, hard cheese, you're going to lose.
Hi.
Hey.
Hi.
How are you?
Good.
You're much shorter than we pictured you.
There's like one and a half of you there, right?
Yeah, well, we're the Bright Sparks. I'm Laura.
This
I'm
is Harry.
I'm Sierra.
And you're the Big Losers, right?
Big Losers.
Yes, that's right, it is. Losers. Yeah.
You're the exactly. Small losers.
Before the trash talk gets too serious, Philip tosses a coin to decide who will pitch first.
Who's gonna call it?
Us heads, because ours are obviously brainy.
Oh, wow, that happened.
Heads it is.
Heads it is.
What does that mean? We're gonna go first?
Mm-hmm.
Awesome.
Sure. Big Shots, you can come with me. Bright Sparks, you're gonna have to wait.
Joining Philip in the pitch is Vice President of Operations, Keith.
All right, Big Shots, give us your pitch.
We're excited about creating something for kids that's a very unique experience for their own. Each individual kid will have their own unique experience, which is something that's very interesting. That will not only brand your cheesecake, but brand an experience, which is what life is about.
It seems Ryan has forgotten the first rule of pitching. Get to the point.
Life is not measured by the breath that you take, but by the moments that take your breath away.
While the company bosses and even his teammates wait for Ryan to get on with it, the Bright Sparks are using their extra time to fine-tune their pitch.
Gentlemen, I'd like to present to you my own cheesecake. Right, now the construction of the cheesecake consists of cookies and cream is, of course, the top. And it's mixed with a cheesecake, just a normal cheesecake.
You know, what seems to work historically is if the product looks great, people eat with their eyes first. Sure. So the product needs to look really, really appealing.
Your brief was to come up with a whole new flavor. And being as smart as you are, I feel the flavor that you've produced today is rubbish. Cookies and cream has been done a number of times, and I suggest that you go back to the table and think about a different flavor.
The comments, in my opinion, I don't feel were negative. I think they're constructive comments that we can actually do and improve on our idea.
So despite a negative reaction, the Big Shots are choosing to look on the bright side. But can the Bright Sparks do any better with their presentation?
Hi, we're the Bright Sparks,
and we are here to pitch our unique, original cheesecake product to you.
Our idea is called Inside Out Trio.
Tasty cheesecake from the inside out.
The three flavors of our cheesecake balls are vanilla strawberry, cookie dough chocolate, and honey nut.
So let me show you what our product would look like on the plate. Sierra? There'll be three beautifully decorated cheesecake balls with delicious sauces drizzled delicately over each.
Here's the model that actually shows the size of what it would be and the different layers that are on the inside.
Tasty cheesecake from the inside out.
Ian.
Well, I have to tell you, it's quite a sophisticated idea. Very unique and upscale. I'm concerned about the size. If this is truly meant to represent your protocept, your example, I think three of these could be quite a challenge for somebody to eat after their meal.
They gave us some really good feedback. Some of it was positive, some of it was negative.
After hearing both pitches, which idea has impressed Philip and Keith the most?
If we can actually make the Bright Sparks idea, I think it would be great and well received.
To me, the product with the strongest potential is the Bright Sparks idea.
So it's the Bright Sparks who have edged ahead, but the Big Shots are determined to get back on track. Not only have they revamped their presentation, but now they're working on a whole new flavor with cheesecake guru, Alan.
I think for something that you guys
want to add a lot of, have a lot of other options to add to, I think it needs to be a little more neutral. I would say something more vanilla. So let's say we wanted to use our vanilla. Let's use our plain batter here. And then caramel will go with a lot. And it doesn't have to be really heavy on caramel, just more of an afternote.
But you can definitely tell the caramel's in there.
I would definitely put some type of a vanilla mousse on top of that and give it a lot more creaminess to it, almost like an ice cream. It's going to pretty much eat like an ice cream.
So we're going to go with the mousse and then the caramel notes in the vanilla base, and it's going to be given an ice cream sort of feeling to it.
The Bright Sparks have decided to size down their cheesecake balls, but there's a question mark over one of their flavors.
I like the flavor, but I don't know what kind of broad appeal that may have. If you guys really want to use your honey, I think it's a great flavor, but I think it needs to be more of a secondary flavor. Maybe if it was more of something more familiar, like a butterscotch or a caramel, and then I would maybe say butterscotch honey, and then that might be something that might be, I'm willing to try that.
Taste
so taste the honey, and then maybe taste the one with the butterscotch.
It's like sticky and sweet.
One thing that kind of worried me today was when we were going to put the butterscotch with the honey, but when I tasted it, it was really good, and I think it really works.
I think that's going to be a really nice combination. I think you guys have some great ideas. I can't wait to put it together for you guys.
Thank you.
All the best.
Thanks.
We've worked really well together. We've all made really good decisions, so we're going to win.
I feel really confident that we're going to beat the Bright Sparks. I just don't think they have a candle to hold to us.
With the day drawing to a close, what does Philip think of the two teams' designs?
If I had to make a decision right now on everything I've seen and all the hard work that's gone into it, I'd have to pick the Bright Sparks.
But the final decision lies with our 25 expert judges. It's decision day. Both teams are on their way to the Beat the Boss USA headquarters to find out who's won.
We did all the right things, so hopefully they'll like what we did.
Well, I'm about to see the product for the first time, and I'm feeling really excited. I'm not sure what it's going to turn out to be like.
Where we would have gone wrong, possibly, I don't think we went wrong.
We're confident in our product, and I think we will win.
If we lost, I'd be gutted to fly home as the losers.
I have a feeling we're going to win because we stuck to the brief, and we're kids. We know what we like.
Welcome to Beat the Boss USA's headquarters. This is the big moment that you've all been waiting for. Well, let's start with the big shots. There it is.
Wow.
Wow.
That is awesome.
Wow.
So you think we're looking at the winning product right now?
Oh.
Yep. Yeah. If not, it's something I'd like to take home with me. Is that okay?
Well, why don't you try it then and find out if it tastes as good as it looks. Dig in.
Oh, wow.
Bright Sparks. Are you hearing this?
Ew!
What do you think, Harry?
Best.
Do you like the idea?
I like the concept, but I think they could have added maybe a few more extras.
Well, that's what the Bright Sparks think.
I think part of that is colored by the competition.
Let's find out what they've created.
All right.
Bright Sparks, you've seen the Big Shots product. Harry, are you still confident about yours, that you can beat them?
Yeah, I like their product, but I probably like mine more.
All right, well, why don't we take a look?
That looks
so nice.
Oh, my God. That is perfect.
Laura, what do you think? You still feel confident that you've won?
Yeah, we're definitely going to win.
Big Shots.
Yes.
This is their idea. They have inside-out cheesecake.
It's a great design, but it's not going to win.
It looks like it's too big for a kid's mouth.
Well, let's see how it tastes. Go ahead, try it.
Oh, my God, that is so good.
Well, both teams, you obviously are very confident in your product, but what matters is what the target market thinks. So why don't you have a seat and let's see what the 25 judges had to say.
Okay. We asked our 25 judges to test both products. To make it fair, they had no idea who designed which one. First, it's the Big Shots My Own Cheesecake.
You can customize it however you want. It's really good. Flavors like paradise, just like nothing I ever tasted before.
I really liked it because it was like kid heaven. You like got cake and chocolate and gummy bears.
That's cool. Awesome.
I like the look of it because it was like smiley face.
There was nothing I did not like about it. Everything was perfect.
And what did the judges make of the Bright Sparks Inside Out Trio?
Yo, my neck.
Give me it, give me it.
Delicious.
I love the strawberry.
I think it's really good. It was really creamy. I like the insides. They're just like an explosion of flavor.
It's hard to eat because it's like in a little ball form.
My favorite flavor was the chocolate. I loved that.
Time to vote.
Well, you saw what the judges had to say. Big shots. They loved that it could be customized, but they thought the vanilla was quite plain. Bright Sparks. They loved that your cheesecake had several flavors, but they said that some of the balls were a little difficult to eat. But who did they vote as the overall winner? I have that right here. The winners. Of the Beat the Boss USA cheesecake product with a tasty 19 votes to 6. Are the Big Shots.
Wow. The bus is air conditioned.
Big Shots, come on over. Let me present to you your trophy. Congratulations.
Oh, look at that.
Great job. There's a limo waiting to whisk you away, so nice. I'm gonna go with you. And Bright Sparks, I'm sorry, but you're gonna have to take the bus.
Mm. Oh. Come on.
Yay. Bye.
Bye. Bye.
Big Shots, congratulations, you've done it. You defeated the Bright Sparks. Yeah. Cheers. Yeah. Cheryl, are you surprised with the result?
I'm not surprised. I was really confident going in, and I just knew that this was a kid's product.
I'm really surprised because we lost to a bunch of losers.
The one thing that I thought that we might have been a little conservative on was the flavor.
Big Shots, you did a great job, but we'll get you next time.
The biggest thing about becoming a businessman or a businesswoman is to really do what you love, and then the money will follow, and you guys did that.
Hey, yeah, good job.
We'll get you next time.
I can't believe you've beaten us, Big Shots. Any chance for a lift?